Hello everyone. In the last videos, we have seen what is carbon and its properties. We have also learned how we can name the carbon compounds and have also seen two important carbon compounds, which were ethanol and ethanoic acid. In this video, we are going to see the uses of carbon in soaps and detergents. A bar of soap and a scoop of detergent has a very typical structure and they work in a very interesting way. I'm sure hardly any of us think how they work. All we are bothered about it is how properly our clothes are clean. The dirt is oily in nature and we know that the oil does not dissolve in water. That is why simply rinsing our clothes with water does not remove the dirt, and we need an external cleansing agent such as soaps and detergent for cleaning our clothes. Let's study the structure of soaps and then detergents and try to understand how they work. A molecule of soap is a sodium or potassium salt of long chain carboxylic acid. Every long chain has the hydrophobic end and the hydrophilic end. The hydrophilic end is the ionic end which dissolves in water, while the hydrophobic end dissolves in the oil. In simple language, we can say that each end behaves as a magnet and attracts their respective material, which are water and dirt. So we can say that the hydrophilic end dissolves in water and the hydrophobic end dissolves in the dirt. When we apply soap to the stain of oil or grease in the cloth, then the molecules of soap take a unique orientation. The hydrophobic ends get attached to the oil and the hydrophilic ends dissolves in the water. And sometimes many molecules get attached in a similar way and form a cluster of molecules in which the hydrophobic tail is in the interior of the cluster, which is near to the dirt, and the hydrophilic end is on the surface of the water and remains attached to the water. This leads to the formation of miscelles. The miscelles stay in solution as colloid and does not precipitate out. That means they do not form insoluble salts due to ion-ion repulsion. That is why on rinsing the clothes with water, the stains along with the miscelles gets removed. You might have wondered why soap solution appears cloudy. This is due to the fact that the soap miscelles have large enough molecules which can scatter light and make the solution appear cloudy. You must have also noticed that sometimes when you apply soap while taking the bath, there is a formation of scum or insoluble precipitate. This is due to the reaction of soap with the calcium and the magnesium salts which are present in the water. These calcium and magnesium salts are also responsible for the hardness of water. So in case of hard water, the soap forms an insoluble scum and it makes it difficult for removal of dirt. The problem of scum formation of soap was overcome by creating another class of compounds known as detergents. The detergents are generally ammonium or sulfonate salts of long chain carboxylic acids. The charge ends of the detergent do not form insoluble precipitate with the calcium and the magnesium ions which are present in the hard water. Thus, we can say that the detergents are effective in hard water. Detergents are generally used for preparing shampoo and other cleaning products. So, if we overlook the whole chapter, we can say that carbon is a versatile element. You can say that it can form the hardest substance such as diamond, while it is also present in the earth atmosphere as carbon dioxide. It is also present in our body as protein and carbohydrates and also form an important constituent in the DNA molecule. And hence, we can conclude that carbon is indeed versatile and a very useful element in nature.